A very good morning all. Today I'll be dealing about research designs or epidemiological methods. So research is known as epidemiology when it occurs among a group of people. So epidemiology, we can split the word epidemiology as epi, demos and ology. So epi means it is distribution, demo means people, you know, demography. And ology is a study. So the study of distribution of something in a group of people is epidemiology. The research is we are searching something again and again. So commonly there are a few methods to conduct a proper epidemiological study. So when we come across a problem which occurs among a large group of people, we need to do an epidemiological study. So there is fundamental difference between an epidemiologist and a clinician. Clinician is people go to a clinician for getting a checkup or getting a treatment for a particular disease. That is an individual going to a doctor for get a treatment. But what happens when many people are affected with the same disease, just like we are seeing the corona or COVID-19 disease? So doctors cannot actually solve the problem. So what happens is epidemiologists go to the public and treat the disease. So what they do is they conduct a study and they find out how it distributes and where it is getting distributed and what is the time, place and person distribution, and they solve the problem. That is all about epidemiological method. So when to conduct epidemiology and how to conduct epidemiology? So it depends on the disease. So basically we know prevalence of anemia, we have seen leptospirosis, we have seen low birth weight, the risk factors, and a conventional suture or stapler which is used for suturing the wounds. So all these are different problems and all these four are to be dealt with different epidemiological studies or epidemiological study designs. So basically a research design or epidemiological study, research and epidemiology is almost the same. Research is we are trying to find out a new solution or a solution for a problem. Epidemiology is the problem occurs among the people. So basically the designs are divided into two, the observational and experimental. It is very clear that one is just an observation and one is an experiment. Okay, so when a clinician is treating a particular patient, an epidemiologist treating a group of people or a mass of people, clinician treats the patient within the clinic or within the hospital, whereas epidemiologists go to the public and treat the disease. He cannot treat a single patient, he has to find out how the disease spreads, where it is getting started. So all this he has to find out and treat the disease, then only the disease will be cured from a mass of people. So observational is an epidemiologist just observing the situation and finding out a solution. It is just like our coronavirus COVID-19 disease. We are not treating the disease by applying any medicine or a vaccination. We are observing where it is getting spread and how fast it is getting spread. So we are asking people to go for a lockdown. So there are a lot of things involved in observation study, but the epidemiologist will not do any purposeful intervention from his side, so he will be just an observer. But whereas in experimental, the clinician or researcher or epidemiologist will do a intervention from his part to find out the cause of a disease or find out the effect of a particular drug. So clinician or researcher or epidemiologist will have a significant role in experimental study, whereas in observation study, he just act as an observer but still find out the solution of the problem. So in the observational studies, we have the major divisions. One is descriptive study and one is analytical study. So in observation study, before that we need to find out a problem. Suppose you imagine a cholera outbreak in your city. So cholera outbreak must have started from a sewage containing water supply, and a lot of people are getting affected. So you are appointed as an epidemiologist and you are going to the location and you are finding out the disease, you are finding out the people, their symptoms, and you are trying to find out where it is started and how it is getting distributed, which all groups of people is getting affected. And finally, you are making a hypothesis. Hypothesis means an assumption, your doubt, without any evidence, without any proper evidence. The data which you collected by asking questions, how, when, where. You ask many questions related to the cholera. What are the symptoms, where it started, how it started, who all are affected. All you ask and make a hypothesis, make an assumption. And you could say that a particular restaurant or particular pump or particular common tap should be an assumption, could be the source of infection, and this many people are affected. So drinking water from this pipe or drinking water from that particular hotel could be the cause of cholera. So you are making an hypothesis. That is a descriptive study. It's a basic thing. The first study should be descriptive study in any epidemiological design. So you have a data, that is the cholera is caused due to drinking water from that particular pipe, a common pipe. But you cannot say that the cholera is due to that disease. To say that, you need to test the hypothesis which was made in descriptive study. So testing hypothesis, you have to do analytical study. So from the data, you need to compare the data. So when you do analysis on the data with a comparison group, that is known as analytical study. So only after analytical study you can say that this could be the reason for that particular disease. So these are the basic observation study. In both case, the epidemiologist is observing it. He is not putting any extra intervention from his part. Is just observing. One is making a hypothesis. Okay, so we'll be seeing some of the descriptive study design. So you can see an article, a study of acute vision lost in postpartum period in HIV associated meningitis people. So it is something like a description of a certain condition. So it is known as a case report, which is just a descriptive study design, one of the descriptive study design. The next one is pneumocystis, carini pneumonia and mucosal candidiasis in homosexual men. So it has become case series. Case series is nothing but a compilation of many case reports. These all are descriptive patterns of a study. They are just describing a certain condition in a few people or a group of people. The next one is the prevalence and determinants of hypertension in a group of people. This has become cross-sectional study because the people will be asked questions only at one point of time. There will not be any follow. Still, they are asking only questions, only the reports will be checked and data will be collected. Okay, so these are, and one more thing which I left out is longitudinal study. So the same cross-sectional study is being repeated, or if there is a follow-up, the same group of people is asked questions after a period of time, that will become longitudinal study or follow-up study. So in all these studies, that is case report, case series, cross-sectional study, longitudinal study, we are just describing condition of people and we are trying to create a hypothesis. We are not trying to analyze anything out of the data, but we are just seeing the data and we are creating a hypothesis. But whereas in analytical study, which is also a part of observation study, we can see that there is one study design which is known as case control study. We'll be dealing in detail about all these study designs, case control and cohort study. But as of now, case control study is nothing but an analytical study. So in all analytical study, that is in case control and cohort, we are trying to test the hypothesis. So there will be always a comparison group. Then only testing of hypothesis is possible. So in this case, that is control group will be there. So this is the comparison group. So risk factors of development of colorectal carcinoma. So these are the patients, and we will be taking one group of people without the disease, that is without the colorectal carcinoma, and we will be comparing the risk factors, and we will try to find out, or we try to test the hypothesis and reach into a conclusion. So this is case control study. This is always a retrospective study. We are going back. We will be asking questions, or we will be taking data from the previous records. But this is one of the famous study, the Framingham Heart study. This is a cohort study. This is a forward-looking study. This study goes to the future. Okay, this study started dated back to 1948, and the study is still going on. So this is known as cohort study. Cohort means a group of people who shares common characteristic. So people with cardiovascular disease, their risk factors will be assessed in the future, or their risk factors will be assessed at frequent interval of time. We will not be asking questions and will be taking data from their previous history. Instead, we will be checking data, we will be collecting data from the follow-ups. Once the study is started, we will keep follow-up at regular interval and we will be collecting data. So such study is known as cohort study, and in cohort study also there will be a comparison group. People who is not developing this cardiovascular disease. At the beginning of the study, cohort study, there will not be any disease in the cohort group. Over the period of time, few will develop the disease and the other will remain as a comparison group. It is little complicated. We'll deal this later. But right now we'll just check the concept. Cohort means a group, and at the beginning of the study there will not be any disease in the group, and over a period of time this cohort will be divided into two, that is diseased and non-diseased, and we have a comparison group, that is non-diseased, and we'll be comparing this and we'll be comparing the risk factors. Whereas in case control study, the study is started with case. Already cases are there. We just need to find out some controls, age and gender match controls, and we'll be comparing and we'll be checking the risk and we'll be testing the hypothesis. So the analytical study has basically two parts, that is two components. One is case control study and cohort study. Case control study means we'll be doing on the cases and we'll be taking controls. Cohort study, we are doing on a group of people. Those people have not developed the particular disease yet. They might develop the disease, suspected disease, in future. So cohort study is always very time consuming, very expensive, very administratively complicated. Whereas case control study is very simple. We can conduct it very easily because case is already there. We just need to find out the control and conduct study. Whereas in cohort study, sometimes the cohort will not turn into two groups over a particular period of time. So it might take years to complete a cohort study. But always God study is better than case control study. So our study designs has become like this, observational and experimental. And descriptive study and analytical study. Descriptive has four parts or four designs: case report, series of case report, that is case series, cross-sectional study. Population will be taken only at one point of time. Longitudinal study, the same group of people will be follow-up at regular intervals over a future period. In analytical study, where the hypothesis will be testing, there are two components: case control and cohort study. Case control is retrospective, cohort is prospective study. In case control, cases are already there, we need to find out the controls, age and gender match controls. In cohort study, the cohort group will not be having any disease at the beginning of the study. Over a period of time, it might develop into a diseased and non-disease. In both the study designs, we need to have a comparison group. In case control study, the control group is our comparison. And cohort study, there will be a non-diseased group for comparison. So finally, we will be testing the hypothesis and we will be doing risk estimation. So all this risk estimation we will be dealing in future classes. So the experimental study design, in the beginning I have told you the basic two designs are observational and experimental. So far we have completed observation study. In observational study, descriptive and analytical, where the researcher or epidemiologist just observing the condition or the disease. Whereas in experimental study design, the clinician or researcher has a significant role, or he will do an intervention purposefully on the people or the study subjects. So you can see that a comparison between desflurane and propofol in improving the laparoscopic sleeve gastrectomy. In this two group of people are getting two different drugs. Okay, so all these drug trials will be experimental study, because two group of people, the researcher are giving two different group of medicine to two different group and finding out their outcome and comparing this and trying to find out which drug is better. In observation study, there will not be any such thing, any intervention, any manipulation from the part of researcher. But in experimental study, there will be manipulation or intervention from the part of researcher. That is, two different drug will be given to two different groups and will be checking the outcome of the disease, outcome of the medicine on the disease. So this is known as randomized control trial. The important part is trial. Trial means the investigator has a significant role. So control means there will be always a control group in the study. Randomized means the groups will be randomly selected. The participants will not be knowing which group they are going to participate. They will be randomly selected to or allocated to the groups. So that is all about randomized control trial. So in experimental study, we have two designs: randomized control trial and non-randomized trials. In non-randomized, only the difference is the participants are not allocated randomly. They will be knowing which group they are being by which group they are getting allocated to or getting participated. So always the randomized trial has a better advantage than the non-randomized. Okay, so all these study designs will be dealing in detail in later classes. So this is all about the epidemiological study design. This is a very broad classification. The first division is observational and experimental. In observational, where the clinician has just an observer role, descriptive and analytical, this is testing hypothesis. Sorry, this is creating hypothesis in descriptive, and in analytical, this is testing hypothesis. In descriptive, we have case report, case series, cross-sectional, longitudinal study designs. In analytical, we have case control and cohort studies. Whereas in experimental study, we have randomized trial and non-randomized trial. This is a very broad classification, but this is apt for to understand the basics of a epidemiological studies. So we'll be dealing in detail about this study within in future classes. Thank you.